Hello everyone, welcome back to Vermont Craft Tours. I'm Sarah Scully, and the last few weeks I've been sharing different tips and notes, dyer's notes from my experiments with natural dyes. So I wanted to continue that today. I did a lot of experimenting last summer, so I have a whole slew of these to kind of report back to you on and let you know what I tried and what worked. And I really am hoping that this is helpful to you and that maybe some of you can repeat my results or repeat my method and get similar results because it would be nice to hone in some of these techniques and see, you know, if we can come up with consistent ways to get good color. So today I'm going to talk about madder, also called rose madder. Madder is used to get a red color, and it's a fairly nondescript ground creeping kind of woody herb type of plant. You wouldn't actually eat it, but it's in that it's similar to a lot of woody herbs. And the part of the plant that you use for dye is the roots. Now up here in Vermont, you can cultivate madder. A lot of people have it in their dye gardens. I haven't planted it yet. It does take about 2 years to mature before you can start using it. So there's a significant time investment. And because of that, thus far, I've just used commercially purchased madder. I've done that in two different preparations. The first is just the dried roots that have been sort of cut up a bit. So it looks like mulch or something. And the way that I prepared that was that I rinsed it in warm water and drained that first rinse off, because you're going to get sort of muddy brown tones. And then you soaked the roots in, a sun tea method to extract the color, and then dyed the yarn, also using that sun tea method where they're in a clear container out, in the sun. The other method that I've used that's worked really well is to use madder extract. That's a powder. I suppose you could buy it in a liquid form too, but of course it'll be more concentrated in a powder. And I think just 2 teaspoons dyed a pound of yarn really nicely, kind of a deep reddish coral shade. So that's very easy to do a sun tea method. Put some water in a clear vessel, and I use those clear plastic storage tubs, and swish the powder around so that it's well distributed, and then stick your yarn, your mordanted yarn in, and go sort of gently swish it every day or so for the first few days to get the color evenly distributed, and then just check on it. Now this sun tea method is a great one to use for things like madder that are temperature sensitive. Madder is very temperature sensitive, and if you get it over the kind of narrow temperature window that it likes, you'll just get brown tones. It'll completely turn on you. So you really have to be careful if you're cooking it. And I've had some bad madder oops. Kind of sessions where I did get, you know, this kind of bricky brown color that wasn't very appealing. So, but I read about the sun tea method at some point in my internet research, and it's nice because the water never gets too hot, and the color really does fasten onto the yarn very well. The downside is it can take a few weeks for the color to really fully bind onto the yarn and really get a saturated tone. And I found that was especially true with the tree bark, or with the kind of bark preparation of the madder where it's chopped up into pieces. The extract version went a lot faster. That was only about a week, and got some really nice color there. So, but the extract is more expensive. So, you know, you have to kind of trade off and figure out what your price point is, and, you know, especially if you're going to sell the yarn, not just your time, but also the materials, of course, go into your cost for that. So all the details for this method will be in the blog post accompanying this video, of course, and you can find that at the link below. And do try some matter and let me know how that works out for you. I'd love to see your results. So thanks for joining me. And keep dyeing yarn, keep experimenting, and let me know how it's going. Cheers.